Now that you have your content figured out and you know what you're going to say, it's time to capture the screen content. But before you push your record button, let's make sure you have everything set up and ready to go. One of the mistakes I see a lot of new video creators make when recording screencasts is that they record their screen as is, meaning their desktop is usually cluttered with programs and file icons. All the applications they use are still open, and all the bookmarks are pinned to their browser are showing. Before you record, you should clean up your computer. Remember, you only will want to show things that are going to be relevant and useful to your viewer. One option to consider is to set up a new user profile on your computer and use that profile for your recordings. The benefit of having a new profile is that you can have it set exactly the way you want it and not have to make any changes when you're ready to record. So, what exactly should you clean up? First, if you're going to show your desktop, either organize or hide the files. Next, close and unpin any unneeded applications. Not only does this visually remove clutter, but it can also free up memory for your computer to use during recording. You'll also want to make sure you've turned off any notifications. This could be from email, your calendar, software updates, social media, or any other that might pop up and ruin a good recording. The background images on your screen can be an issue as well. Either change or make sure the background of your desktop will work well in your video. You don't need to have a solid color, but you want to make sure that it's something that isn't too busy or distracting. Also, make sure it's an image appropriate for you and your brand. If you're recording a browser window, you'll want to hide any of the elements that aren't necessary, like your bookmarks, extensions, or any other non-essential information. For many browsers, you can also set up a unique profile that will remember these settings. Another issue is making sure what you are showing on the screen is clear and easy to see. You'll want to check that whatever you're recording is readable. Is the font size big enough? If the viewer is watching on a small screen, like a mobile device, are they going to be able to see and understand what you're showing? Here are a few other changes you can consider that can help you make a better screencast. One common problem is the creator using their mouse cursor like a laser pointer, or talking with it, which at times looks like this. To counteract this, I recommend going into your computer settings and changing your cursor's pointer speed. It will force you to slow down your movements and be more deliberate as you record. The new speed will take time to get used to, and it may feel awkward at first, but it will help you create a better recording. While you're changing the cursor speed, you may also consider changing the size of your cursor. Although this is less of an issue, as some programs will allow you to do this during the editing process. Now, you're almost ready to record. If you watched previous videos, you know that I recommend walking through the steps of your screencast. It doesn't hurt to walk through the process you'll be recording one more time. As you walk through the process, make sure that you have all the data, information, access, like usernames and passwords, and everything else that you need on hand. This is the last check to make sure that windows, pop-ups, and everything else will show up when and where you expect it. Next up, let's select the area you're going to record and provide some tips to keep in mind during the recording process.